Good morning students. In this video we are going to see what are semiconductors, what are the types of semiconductors, and also why do we need semiconductors. I am Dr. Annie Frieda, postgraduate teacher from SLB Government High Secondary School, Nagarkoil. Silicon is a semiconductor and its valency is 4. Silicon atoms valence electrons are 1, 2, 3, 4. And the valence electrons 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. This is an intrinsic semiconductor, which means there is no impurity in it. The conductivity of this semiconductor could be increased by doping an atom with valency 3 or valency 5, and that becomes p-type semiconductor or n-type semiconductor. We shall see it in detail. Doping means adding impurity atom to the intrinsic semiconductor in the ratio 10^6:1. Here we are doping antimony Sb with silicon. The valence electron of antimony is 5, and so we have a free electron in it. The antimony has 5 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. By doping indium with silicon, we get a p-type semiconductor. 3 electrons of indium cannot make bonding with all the 4 electrons of nearby silicon, and so a hole is formed. This helps to increase the conductivity of the semiconductor. This is the structure of a doped semiconductor. This is an n-type semiconductor having excess free electrons. It is more interesting to see how the free electrons are moving inside a semiconductor, causing conductivity when an external field acts on the semiconductor. When we reverse the direction of the external electric field, the electron moving direction also changes. Students, I hope that you have understood the concept of doping, types of semiconductors, and also how free electrons or holes help in enhancing conductivity of a semiconductor. Thank you. Thanks for watching. If there is any doubt, please ask in the comment box.